फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ आलोक शेपुरकर। आई एम एग्जीक्यूटिव वाइस प्रेसिडेंट एंड हेड ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज एट HDFC एसेट मैनेजमेंट कंपनी लिमिटेड। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट बिल्डिंग रेजिलिएंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस। एज वी नो, रेजिलिएंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस आर नॉट द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच विल सर्वाइव थ्रू क्राइसिस, बट दीज आर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस विच विल थ्राइव एंड गिव आउटस्टैंडिंग रिजल्ट्स फॉर इट्स एम्प्लॉयज एंड इट्स शेयर होल्डर। So in other words, these organizations are able to create value on an ongoing basis regardless of the environmental realities. So resilient organizations, as they thrive through uncertainty, they have two peculiar capabilities. One is foresight. They are able to see what is lying ahead, and they do this by continuously creating war gaming and painting different scenarios and have strategies to overcome those scenarios. Number two, these are the organizations which are able to convert a crisis into great opportunity or strategic advantage, and therefore they say, don't waste a good crisis. For example, today when most of the passenger planes are parked at airports, some of the top companies are converting their passenger planes into vaccine carrier so that COVID vaccine can reach to different parts of the world, and therefore creating some value for their investors and customers. Now, when it comes to how do they run business as usual, there are three attributes these organizations have embedded in them. Number one is leadership and culture. This is built as an adaptability to different situation. Their leaders are able to think through, ideate different scenarios and guide their organizations to overcome the situations. The fabric of culture gives them tremendous advantage, because what you invest for years together helps you to sail through in crisis, because crises don't come every day. They come once in a while, but the building a culture is an investment which is long term. Second thing is, they are able to build the network and relationships. Their network and relationships built over a longer period of time. They are able to forge alliances. They are able to break the silos within the organization. They are heavily relying on the talent within. They bring tremendous capacity and capability to build the organization. At times, they are surplus on that. And this is how they leverage the internal knowledge which has been accumulated over a period of time. They forge alliances with competition. For example, we know some of the FMCG companies have shared common warehouses. Some of the Coca-Cola company or some of the soft drink companies have shared their transportation systems with competition so that they can create strategic advantage for the company and still survive through the crisis in the market. Third and very important attribute is change readiness. They have well-defined purpose, they are proactive, and they have very well-planned structure. They also continuously stress test their capability to overcome such crisis. Let me share one example from cricket world. In 1983 World Cup final, when India scored 183 against West Indies, Kapil Dev, after explaining the game plan, told the team that if we get a few early wickets, we will be in the game and we will win the match. And we know rest is history. So leaders in resilient organizations are able to change the perspective of their teams and therefore conquer all the situation. So this was my brief introduction about building resilient organizations. I am sure you have found it useful. Have fantastic learning ahead. Thank you very much to LeapVault for creating this opportunity.